Next topic is basic views. Now we are going to take some particular views or the views which are generally used and can be used as the base for construction or production of new designs. And that's why these are known as basic views, because they can be used as the base. Means on the basis of these views, we can produce variety of views or variety of designs. And basic views are generally of three types, as mentioned here. One is plain view, another is twill view, third one is sateen or sateen view. This is pronounced as sateen, and here it is sateen. Here we are using big E, here we are using small e. So sateen and sateen. These are the three basic views. On the basis of these views, we can produce or we can derive or we can get different modifications of these views. Plain view can be derived, many designs like rib structures and offset structures can be produced on the basis of plain view. Similarly, wave twill, herringbone twill, broken twill, transpose twill, many other types of twills can be produced or can be modified on the basis of these twill designs. And similarly, Venetian, buckskin, or many extensions of sateen and sateen can be produced on the basis of sateen and sateen. And many more designs like crepe or diamond, diaper, these are generally modifications of either plain, twill, sateen, or sateen. So many more designs can be derived from these desert designs by using them as the base. And that's why these are known as basic views. So one by one, we will try to understand all these three views. First, we are going through this most simple and most easiest but most widely used view, that is known as plain view. So students, plain view is the simplest of all woven fabric structures. Means if we compare among all the designs or the views which we can produce, this plain view is the simplest view. And also you can say it is the smallest. This is the simplest and smallest view of all woven fabric structures. And that's why this is also most widely used view. So plain view is the simplest of all woven fabric structures, interlacing in what is happening. Because as I have defined the view, view is the specific order of interlacement of warp and weft. If a specific order of interlacement of warp and weft is termed or given a specific name. So if we are giving a name plain, it means it is having a specific order of interlacement. If that order of interlacement is found in a particular structure, then only it will be termed as plain view. So interlacing in a one under one over formation means one down, one up formation, alternate order, one up, one down formation. All the ends and peaks are interlacing in one up, one down interlacing order and repeats over two warp ends and two weft peaks. Or this is repeating only on two ends and two peaks, as shown here. Two ends, first end, second end, first peak, second peak. So design is completed in two cross two. So it repeats on two ends and two peaks. This gives the fabric balance with equal amounts of horizontal and vertical thread showing. Iska ek aur speciality hai. Warp aur weft ka equal amount aapko fabric ke upar dikhai dega. So it is forming a balance. This gives the fabric balance with equal amounts of horizontal and vertical threads showing. An historic example of a plain view fabric is illustrated here by taking a size 2 cross 2 and one up, one down. Second end is one down, one up. In this way, we can represent plain view. So students, you can see this is the simplest structure possible, smallest structure possible. And these are the main characteristics of plain view. And here we have concluded the two important characteristics or two important structural characteristics, which is part of their structure. One is two threads interlace in exactly opposite order. Two threads interlace in exactly opposite order, and another is one of one down order of interlacement results in maximum intersection. Is it clear? Here you can see first end and second are exactly opposite of each other. Opposite means when it is up, it is down, and when it is down, so when first end is down, say where the first end is down, the next end is up. Similarly, if you see peak wise, here the weft is down, cross, we have filled in square. It means either we can filled in or we can use cross, and cross means warp up. So here it is on the first peak, weft is down, here weft is up. On second peak, जहां पे ये डाउन था यहाँ पे अप हो गया है वेफ्ट, और जहां पे ये अप था वहां पे डाउन हो गया. इट मीन्स एंड्स एंड पिक्स आर एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट, आर हैविंग एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट ऑर्डर्स एंड अल्टरनेट ऑर्डर. अल्टरनेट मीन्स वन अप वन डाउन, एक बार ऊपर एक बार नीचे, ऐसे ऑर्डर्स को हम अल्टरनेट ऑर्डर बोलते हैं. सो दीज आर द टू कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्लेन व्यू. Two threads in two adjacent threads means neighboring threads interlace in exactly opposite order, and one up one down order of interlacement is there, and because one up one down interlacement order is there, so it is resulting in a maximum number of intersections. Or किसी भी view में इतने intersections नहीं होंगे. Intersection means whenever the thread is changing its position from face to back or back to face, it is creating one intersection point. It is creating one intersection. जब भी thread, चाहे warp thread, चाहे weft thread, face से back में जा रहा है और back से face में आ रहा है, means up से down हो रहा है, down से up हो रहा है, means cross से blank बन रहा है या blank से cross बन रहा है, जहां भी cross के बाद blank आ रहा है, इसका मतलब वहां पे intersection point create हो रहा है. Similarly, you can see in this design, यहाँ पे up है और यहाँ down हो रहा है, इसका मतलब यहाँ एक intersection बन रहा है. और नेक्स्ट वीक में वापस यही यहाँ पर रिपीट होगा, तो ये जो ब्लैंक है अगेन यहाँ पर अप होगा, जो डाउन है वापस अप होगा. यानी कि एक इंटरसेक्शन यहाँ पर हो रहा है और एक इंटरसेक्शन यहाँ हो रहा है, यानी कि दो पिक के अंदर दो इंटरसेक्शंस हो रहे हैं, चाहे वो आप पिक वाइज देखें चाहे आप एंड वाइज देखें. विद इन द रिपीट ऑफ टू क्रॉस टू देर आर इन एंड वाइज यू सी टू इंटरसेक्शन, एवरी एंड इज हैविंग टू इंटरसेक्शन और एवरी पिक इज हैविंग टू इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट्स. ये पहला इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट इसका, ये दूसरा. सिमिलरली इसका इंटरसेक्शन यहाँ पर, और अगेन वापस अप से ये जब डाउन होगा तो भी इंटरसेक्शन, यानी कि दो की रिपीट में दो इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट्स, दैट इज मैक्सिमम. सो मैक्सिमम इंटरसेक्शंस आर पॉसिबल इन दिस डिजाइन, एंड ड्यू टू दिस इट इज हैविंग सम स्पेसिफिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. दिस इज स्मॉल वन, सो नाउ इट इज विजिबल. सो हियर यू कैन सी दैट अगेन इट्स अ प्लेन व्यू. It is known by various name in the industry. Some popular names are Calico, Tabby. इसको हम Calico या Tabby, these are the trade names of the view used in the industry. So it can be named as Calico or Tabby. Sometimes in the examination, it may be asked construct a Tabby view. It means you have to construct plane view. It is the simplest of all views, having a repeat size of 2. The range of application of the view is wide. इसका जो एप्लीकेशन है दैट इज फॉर अ वेरी वाइड रेंज ऑफ फैब्रिक. हाउएवर इट इज अ सिंपलेस्ट एंड स्मॉलेस्ट व्यू, बट इसका जो एप्लीकेशन है, इसको जो यूज हम करते हैं, दैट इज यूज फॉर अ वेरी वाइड वेराइटी और वाइड रेंज ऑफ फैब्रिक्स. द प्लेन व्यू हैज द फॉलोइंग कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. इट हैज द मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ बाइंडिंग पॉइंट्स, मीन्स इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट्स. एज आई मेंशन्ड इन द प्रीवियस स्लाइड, इट इज हैविंग मैक्सिमम आउट ऑफ टू इंटरसेक्शंस आर देयर विद इन द रिपीट ऑफ two intersection point. So that is maximum possible intersection point. So it is having the maximum number of intersection points or binding points. The threads interlace on alternate order of one up, one down. This is the main characteristic. All the threads are having the interlacing order one up, one down. The thread density is limited because many high number of intersection points. So the space between threads will be less. So density of warp means EPI and density of weft means PPI will be limited. Cloth thickness and mass per unit area are limited because density is limited. So cloth thickness will be limited, and the grams per unit, the grams per meter square will be also limited. It produces a relatively stronger fabric that is obtained by any other simple combination of threads, excepting that of gauze or cross weaving. Gauze and cross weaving हम नहीं पढ़ रहे हैं, but इसको आप इतना समझ सकते कि this is another it is requiring some other attachments and a particular weaving process is there which is known as gauze or cross weaving. But here we are taking only the simple woven fabrics. So among the simple woven fabrics, the plain weave, the fabric constructed in plain weave is relatively stronger as compared to other weaves. However, this is simplest and smallest design, but the fabric produced by plain weave or in plain weave are the strongest as compared to other weaves. Here we have shown the plain weave in a bigger size instead of 2x2. For better representation, we are indicating it in more number of threads. Here I have indicated in 8x8. So however it is, the repeat size is 2x2, but we are taking multiple repeats of it for better representation. So it is indicated in 2x2. At the side, we have some sectional diagrams which are not in your syllabus. So we are not taking that one. You can understand it. Only here we have shown the configuration of the threads with respect to here, the one end is shown, one up, one down, one up, one down. And here we have shown in placing of weft through the warp threads. Just a minute, I have some urgent piece of work. Just. Yes, next one is just a minute. I have some urgent work. Just a minute. Sorry, there was urgent work. That's why I was interrupted. Sorry for that. Here we have indicated a plain view with all the constituent elements of fabric structure. Here we have indicated the plain view in 4x4. So here you can see one up, one down, one up, one down. Second end, one down, one up, one down, one up. One up, one down, one up, one down. One down, one up, one down. So you can see all the ends are working in alternate order and adjacent ends are exactly, adjacent ends and peaks are exactly opposite of each other, which is the this characteristic of the plain view. The ends work in alternate order and adjacent ends are opposite of each other. Only this type of structure can be termed as plain view. Now here, I have taken three types of drafting possible for plain view. One is only on two hills because we have two types of interlacement. So just following the principle of drafting, first end passing through first hill frame and simultaneously copying it here in the lifting plan, one up, one up, one down, or later on also you can copy it. Then move on the second end. Is it same with the first or different? Just check and you can see it is different. So here, if you are taking one up, one down here, and it is one down, one up, so it is different. So first end, we have passed through first hill frame. So naturally, now we have to pass the second end from the second hill frame. So we are passing it through the second hill frame. Then move on the third end, compare with the previous two ends, as we have taken in the method of construction of draft and lifting plan from given design. I am following the same principle of drafting here. So this is again same as first. First ko humne first hill se pass kiya hai, to third end bhi first hill se pass hoga. The ends which are working in similar order are passed to the same hill frame. Then move on the fourth hill frame, compare with the previous ends. This is exactly same as second end. Second end ko humne second hill allot kiya hai, to hum isko bhi second hill se hi pass karenge. And we have indicated the mark on the second second horizontal space and this vertical space. This is fourth end and this is second hill frame. So you can say first end and third end are passing through first hill frame, second end and fourth hill ends are passing through second hill frame. And because it is first hill frame shown here in the by the vertical space number one in the lifting plan, so it will have same interlacing order, same working order is the end number one or end number three. And end number one and three are having one up, one down, one up, one down. So it will be copied here. Similarly, move on the second hill frame. See which ends are passing through it. So second end and fourth end are passing through it. So dono mein se kisi ek ka working order dekh le, because dono ek se pass ho rahe hain, to unka working order same hoga, tabhi wo ek se pass ho rahe hain. To kisi ek ka dekh le, one down, one up, and copy it here. The same will be the working order of the hill number two, because they are passing through hill number two. So hill number two ka aur jo ends hill number two se pass ho rahe hain, unka working order same hona chahiye. In this way, we can construct draft and lifting plan in two hill frames. So this is the first case we have taken with the first draft. Now, because whenever we are going for a dense fabric means which is having higher EPI. And EPI is higher, it means more number of ends will be there on the weaver's beam. So according to the number of ends on the weaver's beam, we decide that how many hills we have to use. Our required hills is only two, but the load of the hills will increase if number of ends on the weaver's beam are very high. So keeping in mind the number of ends on the weaver's beam, to reduce the load on each hill frame, sometimes instead of, however, required yield is two, but instead of two, we are going for multiple repeats of two, like four hills, or maybe six hills, or maybe eight hills, so that the load will be shared. Jo do hill frame se, for example, 4,000 ends are there on the weaver's beam. Is case mein kya hoga? 2,000 first hill se pass honge, or 2,000 second hill se pass honge. And the load will be very high on the first hill and second hill. And if the load is very high, then wear and tear of the parts will be very high. So to avoid that or to reduce that, what we are doing, instead of two, we are going to four hill frames. So we are passing first end from first hill frame, because jitne ends hai utni hill frames hai, so we can go for straight order. So first from first, second from second, third is same as first, but here, because we have to reduce the load, so सेम होते हुए भी हम इसको दूसरा हिल फ्रेम अलॉट कर रहे हैं, थर्ड हिल फ्रेम, और ये सेकंड से सेम है तब भी हम इसको नेक्स्ट हिल अलॉट कर रहे हैं, दैट इज फोर्थ हिल फ्रेम. तो अभी क्या होगा, 1000 एंड्स फ्रॉम दिस, 1000 फ्रॉम सेकंड, 1000 फ्रॉम दिस एंड 1000 फ्रॉम दिस. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ 2000 एंड्स पासिंग थ्रू वन हिल फ्रेम, हियर वी आर पासिंग 1000 एंड्स फ्रॉम ईच हिल फ्रेम, एंड इन दैट वे वी आर एबल टू रिड्यूस द लोड ऑफ द हिल फ्रेम्स, सो दैट वेयर एंड टियर ऑफ द पार्ट्स ऑफ कैन बी रिड्यूस्ड. It is another way of presentation of draft. This is straight draft. It is known as skip draft. And if we are taking this draft, this draft, we will get this lifting plan, because four hill frames are there. So first will be copied on first, second will be copied on second, third will be copied on third, and fourth will be copied on fourth. So you can see this second lifting plan is exactly same as design. So it means we can conclude that when the draft is straight, the lifting plan will be same as design. This is skip drafting order, which is not our in syllabus, so we are skipping it. If you are taking skip drafting order, we are getting this type of lifting plan, which is having certain advantages, but it is not part of our syllabus, so we are leaving it. Finally, it is denting plan. So as I mentioned, ends per dent for plane weave is 2. So we have indicated here 2 consecutive threads in one line, 2 consecutive marks in one line. It means these 2 ends are passing through same dent. And then हमें change of dent show करना है, तो we are moving the next line and we are indicating third end and fourth end are passing from same dent because they are in one line. And again in next repeat, वापस हम first line में आ जाएंगे क्योंकि ये next repeat में यहाँ पे आएगा. It means the denting order of 2 can be indicated by, on graph paper in this manner. So this students, it is design, draft, lifting plan and denting plan. This is design, another draft, corresponding lifting plan and denting plan. And this we are not covering it. So this is all about the plane weave. We have taken all the important parts of plane weave. So if you have any question, you can ask. Don't hesitate, feel free to ask. We have taken a very small topic, but it is very important topic for particularly for you students. Basic weaves are very important because most of the fabric are constructed with basic weaves. And you whatever the fabric you are getting, mostly you will find them in the basic weaves. So knowledge of basic weaves is very important for textile chemistry students. So if you have any problems, you can ask. We have started the topic with this slide. So if you have any question related with this slide, you can ask here. It is not lustring, it is illustrating. So is it clear? Plain view.
Then sir, 4000. Sir, sorry.
Yes.
Sir, 4000 end ka wapas repeat kijiye na, sir.
Yes, yes. Wo jab slide aata hai, toh main repeat karta hoon. Is slide mein koi question hai?
No, sir.
Yeah. Very simple view we have indicated, and that is minimum required size. Generally, we are indicating in 2x2, but some special reasons or for better representations, we are going for 4x4. Or 6x6 or higher sizes. These two points are clear. These are the characteristic of the structure of plane weave. It is work. The interlacing order is one up, one down, and that's why maximum number of intersections are there. And due to maximum number of intersections and these exactly opposite order of interlacing adjacent threads, the plane weave is producing strongest fabric because as the number of intersections are increasing in the fabric, as the number of intersections are increasing in the weave, more the number of intersections, more will be the strength of the fabric. And due to this, and also because they are exactly opposite order, adjacent threads are interlacing in exactly opposite order. So we can say due to these two reasons, the fabric constructed in plane weave are stronger as compared to other. So here in the characteristics, we have taken at the fifth point, it produces a relatively stronger fabric. Sometimes in the examination, it may be asked, the fabric constructed in plane view are relatively stronger. Explain. So your explanation will be, the answer will be this slide. One reason is one up, one down interlacing order, which results in maximum number of intersections, and more the intersections, stronger is the fabric. And adjacent threads are exactly opposite of each other, so they provide maximum support to each other. And this because adjacent threads are providing maximum support, so the fabric constructed in plane weave will be stronger as compared to other fabric, other weave. Here, a simple representation of plane weave in 8x8 is shown here. Yes, actually that example I have taken, just assuming that there are 4,000 ends on the weaver's beam. So if 4,000 ends on the weaver's beam are there, and we are using only 2 heel frames. So one end is passing through one heel frame, another end is passing to another heel frame, and again the next end is passing through same heel frame. So if we are having 4,000 ends and we are having only 2 heel frames, naturally 2,000 will pass through first heel frame and 2,000 will pass through second heel frame. That was the example. But if we are going for 4 heel frames for the same V, then what will happen? Because we have 4 heel frames, so instead of passing 2,000, we will pass 1,000 from this, 1,000 from this, 1,000 from this, and 1,000 from this. So total 4,000 ends will be shared by 4 heel frames. It means 1,000 from each heel frame instead of 2,000 in this case. And if it is 1000 in from one yield frame and 2000 from one yield frame, you can see, you can compare the load bear by the yield frames. So here the load bear by the yield frame number one and two will be just double of the load bear by yield number one, two, three, and four here in this case. So two, depending on, suppose we have only 2000 ends on the reverse beam, then this draft is sufficient. Two yield frames are sufficient. Because as the number of hills are increasing, weaving cost is increasing. And as the weaving cost is increasing, fabric cost is increasing. So that point also we have to keep in our mind. We have to keep in our mind the efficiency of the machine as well as the cost of the fabric. Techno-commercial, both the aspect we have to cover. Whenever you are working in the industry, either it is spinning, weaving, or your chemistry processing units. The main motto of a textile chemistry student or textile technology student or an engineer should be that they have to consider both the points, technical point as well as economical point. Marketing people are just concerned with the costing part and quality part of the fabric, but they are not concerned with the technical part, efficiency part, production of the department, because technical person are responsible to answer for production. So it is the responsibility of production people, and engineers are working in production. So they have to also consider the efficiency part or wear and tear of the parts, because that will increase the weaving cost. So that should be considered by the engineers who are working in the department. So you have to consider both the points. It should be technically good as well as it should be economical. Aapne technically good or achhi quality ka fabric bana diya hai, but जो कोस्ट आया है उसका मार्केट में वो कॉम्पेटेबल ही नहीं है, तो मार्केटिंग पीपल विल नॉट बी एबल टू सेल द फैब्रिक. एंड फाइनली अगर आप फैब्रिक सेल नहीं कर रहे हैं, इट इज स्टॉक आपका बढ़ रहा है इंडस्ट्री का, देन यू हैव टू आंसर फॉर दैट. सो दैट पॉइंट आई वांटेड टू क्लियर हियर इन विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस एग्जांपल. एनी अदर क्वेश्चन?
यस सर,
थैंक यू
सर.
कोई एक भी
बनाने से चलेगा क्या सर एग्जाम में?
Yes, only one draft. If it is asked specific that construct in four yield frames, then go for this. Otherwise, if it is not mentioned, you can go with the two yield frames only. And if it is asked with denting plan, then you have to go for 4x4. क्योंकि denting plan का repeat आपका 4 में complete हो रहा है, इसलिए मैंने यहाँ पे 4x4 लिया. अगर denting plan नहीं पूछा है तो आप इसको केवल 2x2 में भी बना सकते हैं. View 2x2 में बन जाएगा, ड्राफ्ट भी 2x2 में बन जाएगा इतना सा, और लिफ्टिंग प्लान भी 2x2 का कंप्लीट हो जाएगा. बट अगर डेंटिंग प्लान बनाना है तो डेंटिंग प्लान के लिए मिनिमम 4 एंड्स चाहिए, क्योंकि दो हमें यहाँ शो करने हैं और दो हमें यहाँ शो करने हैं, तब डेंटिंग प्लान का रिपीट कंप्लीट होगा. और ऐसा नहीं होगा कि डेंटिंग प्लान तो आप 4 एंड्स में बनाए और डिजाइन आप 2 एंड्स में बनाए, ये नहीं होगा. डिजाइन, ड्राफ्ट और डेंटिंग प्लान में नंबर ऑफ एंड्स इक्वल होने चाहिए. एंड्स आर कॉमन इन वीव, ड्राफ्ट एंड डेंटिंग प्लान. और इसीलिए हम इसकी लोकेशन ऐसी लेते हैं, जस्ट व्यू के ऊपर ड्राफ्ट लेते हैं, ड्राफ्ट के ऊपर डेंटिंग प्लान लेते हैं, ताकि एंड्स एक ही लाइन में आ रहे हैं. इसका इसमें जो पहला एंड, पहला वर्टिकल स्पेस है, इसका पहला वर्टिकल स्पेस और इसका भी पहला वर्टिकल स्पेस एक ही लाइन में आ रहा है. और लिफ्टिंग प्लान को हम इसके पैरेलल इसलिए लेते हैं क्योंकि पिक्स कॉमन है यहाँ पर. ये इसका फर्स्ट पिक और इसका फर्स्ट पिक पैरेलल है, इसका सेकंड पिक पैरेलल है, इसका थर्ड पिक और इसका थर्ड पिक पैरेलल है, इसका फोर्थ पिक और फोर्थ पिक पैरेलल. तो ये पोजीशंस इसकी फिक्स रहेगी जो लोकेशन से, दैट इज आल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट. ऐसा नहीं कि आपने लिफ्टिंग प्लान यहाँ बना दिया, इट विल बी इनकरेक्ट. डेंटिंग प्लान आपने यहाँ बना दिया, दैट विल बी इनकरेक्ट. इनकी पोजीशंस फिक्स हैं विद रिस्पेक्ट टू वी. आपने वी कहाँ इंडिकेट किया, उसी के अकॉर्डिंग ड्राफ्ट डेंटिंग प्लान इंडिकेट होगा, उसी के अकॉर्डिंग लिफ्टिंग प्लान इंडिकेट होगा. और इसलिए आप ग्राफ जब डिजाइन करें, ग्राफ को जब एलोकेट करें वी, ड्राफ्ट, लिफ्टिंग प्लान के लिए, तो आपको ग्राफ की, आपके पास ग्राफ साइज क्या है वो सब देख करके आपको करना है. अगर ऑलरेडी आपका ग्राफ काफी फिलअप हो गया है और ये पूरा कंप्लीट एक ग्राफ पे नहीं आएगा, ऐसा नहीं कि आपने व्यू और ड्राफ्ट यहाँ बना दिया, डेंटिंग प्लान आप सेकंड पेज पे बना रहे, दैट इज नॉट अलाउड इन द एग्जामिनेशन. ऑल द पार्ट्स ऑफ वन क्वेश्चन शुड बी अटेम्प्टेड ऑन वन पेज ओनली, देन इट बिकम्स वेरी इजी फॉर द एग्जामिनर ऑल्सो. अदरवाइज समटाइम्स आपने सेकंड पे बनाया और एग्जामिनर उसको चेक करने से रह गया, आपको तो लगेगा कि मैंने पूरा क्वेश्चन अटेम्प्ट किया बट एग्जामिनर को का चेक होने से रह गया है, तो हो सकता है वो पार्ट आपका 2 मार्क्स का हो और वो आपका रह जाए, तो आप जज भी नहीं कर पाएंगे कि वो चेक करने से रह गया. और इस तरह की मिस्टेक से कई बार हम थोड़े थोड़े नंबर लूज कर देते हैं. तो दैट पॉइंट ऑल्सो यू टू कंसिडर कि आप ड्राफ्ट डिजाइन करें या कोई भी क्वेश्चन आप अटेम्प्ट कर रहे हैं तो डिजाइन ऑन ए पर्टिकुलर पेज ओनली. पर्टिकुलरली ग्राफ का तो होना ही चाहिए कि सारे पार्ट्स एक ही ग्राफ पे आए. अगर एक ग्राफ में आपने कोई और व्यूज बना दिए और उतना स्पेस नहीं है तो गो फॉर द सेकेंड ग्राफ. ओके, सो इफ देयर इज एनी क्वेश्चन वी कैन वी हैव स्टिल 1.5 मिनट. Otherwise, we can end the class. So, thank you, students.